Where should we begin? A few questions.
Well, my chosen subject, the 1980 World Snooker Final, frame 16.
Yes. How are you both feeling?
Oh, not that again. Please, please.
Well, you mean about fostering?
Well, things generally. Well, Trudy in particular.
Oh. It's sad. I mean, you know. It's hard to take in. You've got a child in your care who's doing so well and...
Yes, then... well, it was sad. But, I mean, death is part of life, isn't it? It was terrible at the time. It was shocking. It was a shock. Such a waste. I mean, not for us, but a waste of her, if you see what I mean. I'm not sure that I do, but there we are.
And did you find the bereavement counselling helped? I mean, if you wanted to, we could arrange...
No, we're fine, we're fine, we're fine. I'm just getting... to be honest, I'm getting a little bit fed up with this kid love stuff.
So as far as you're concerned, well, where we're concerned, do you think you're ready to get back into the swing of things?
Yes, yes, absolutely.
We're over the worst of it, all of us.
So if I was to say to you, well, speaking theoretically, that we had a child we wanted to place tomorrow...
Ah, well, we've got a bit of a practical problem right now. We're working all hours, both of us. We had a bit of a overdraft creep up on us.
Oh. Well, that's another area where counselling could...
No, we're responsible adults. We can, you know, we'll deal with it.
Still, in view of your present circumstances, I think, well, shall we say, big emergencies only, something like that, just for now.
We're ready and willing to take anything that you want to throw at us.
You were a bit twitchy in there, weren't you?
Yeah, well, you know it gets on my nerves. Anyway, I've got to go and see Roy.
Ah, could you do the shopping?
Yes, yes, yes.
You know, the logical thing to do would be to sell Trudy's bike, not give it away.
No, well, no, that wouldn't be right, would it?
Are you all right? Your legs, have you been cycling again?
No, carpet laying. I've only done two, and my knee's like a broken-down racehorse. I want to see my elbows.
Oh, I should look forward to that, then.
It's not funny. Here we go. Bicycle one, the riding off.
Oh. Yes, it's beautiful. Immaculate. Are you sure you want to do this?
Yeah.
Yeah, if you're up against it financially.
I'm not selling it.
Oh, but that's worth a bit.
How many people have I got to tell? I'm not selling it.
Well, it's a good cause. We're very grateful. Yeah, talking about good causes, did you ever meet Morris? He used to be on the desk here sometimes.
Don't think so, no.
Dead skinny, ginger hair. You'd know him if you'd seen him.
Oh, he's getting married in a couple of weeks. Second time round. Yeah, he wants a video of it. Can't pay anything, but he'll cover your expenses.
What do you mean he can't pay anything? What's he doing on the cheap or something because it's his second marriage? What kind of bloke is he?
Hold on. Morris has got kids to support, that's all.
Well, fine. I've got kids to support. Why should I be taken advantage of?
What's that with you, Tom? I thought it was something you liked doing.
I've got enough to do. Thanks for thinking of me, but no thanks.
Thanks for the bike, anyway.
He gets these sudden mood changes. You never know quite where you are with him.
It could be his age, some kind of phantom menopause. You describe it, I'll write it up.
I'm serious, Mim.
You should never get serious about a man. That's been my big discovery this year.
Oh, yeah? Well, what's this, then?
Where did you get that?
Database dates at the Premier Singles Computer Dating Service.
Yes, well, so what? That's exactly my point. I want male company, but I don't want anything serious.
She was serious enough to pay 50 quid to join.
Not a lot. In the search for uncomplicated pleasures.
Well, it sounds a bit dangerous to me. You could end up being assaulted by somebody with the same taste in music.
Well, it's too late, because I filled in one of those a week ago.
Did you?
As a result of which, I'm meeting a very sensitive man in a shopping centre this evening.
Oh, men, you can't.
In daylight hours with plenty of people around. I'm not a complete fool.
Oh, we'll have to differ on that.
Oh, can you give me a decision, George? I'm doing the letter now. The deep pile. How many metres?
Hang on. Elbow in, elbow in.
This way.
Another one? I didn't see him coming, did you?
Goodbye. It's been a pleasure.
Joan, please, who are all these men?
My private life is none of your concern, George Grizzly.
What are you saying?
And must you do that sort of thing in here? It's not very professional.
Susan?
Tom!
Hi.
We can't keep meeting like this.
Joan?
No.
Joan?
There you are.
Good grief, what happened to you? What is that stuff?
Hot pot. The pressure cooker went off.
Hot pot. Careful.
Wait. I want the yellow pages. I'm in need of a whole maintenance firm. Stove's expired. Walls look as though the elephants had an accident all over them.
There's nothing to what you look like. You look like you're
covered
in it.
Come down here looking for sympathy, isn't it? I think I better phone
back. What about my papers?
Smith, what happened to him?
He became a signwriter and moved to St. Albans.
Good-looking boy he was. That was the trouble with my ex. I always went for the looks. There was nothing there underneath. Bastard.
There's plenty of Billy Smith, though. Last time I saw him, he was enormous. Fat and 50. Do you remember? He was the one that always had the pocket money. Always buying sweets.
Well, we all change, I suppose. Life leaves its mark. You're just the same, though.
How do you mean?
Still got that kind of puppy thing. You were really sweet.
I never thought you'd even notice me.
Funny, when you meet people, they keep turning up.
Yeah. Must invite you over sometime.
I'm ex-directory. Well, I'm not in it yet. Hang on a sec.
Do that again and you'll be missing vital parts of your anatomy. I've got better things to do than to play footsie with a cheapskate, crutch-orientated baboon. In fact, I've got better things to do, period.
Hello, Tom. There's a pervert back there who's far too old to wear Levi's, and I'd take it as a favour if you give him a fat lip. I'd do it myself, but I don't believe in violence on first dates. Hello?
It's my sister-in-law. Oh, thank you. Thanks.
Never knew you wore pyjamas, Gran.
Well, it's not something I go around shouting about. Besides, I'd feel foolish floating about in a negligee. These are sensible.
They're men's pyjamas, aren't they?
They might be, but I can assure you no man has ever set foot in these.
Oh, no, I didn't mean... Sorry.
Now, the last I heard, and it's a while ago now, is that I snore from time to time. You'll tell me if I do in the morning.
Well, it's only for one night anyway, isn't it?
The fun.
No, I blame you.
Oh, really?
If your date hadn't turned out wrong, you wouldn't have got her over here so soon, and she may have changed her mind. Not that that's ever likely with Joan.
It's only for one night. And anyway, what about your date?
It wasn't a date, it was a chance meeting.
Oh, yeah, another chance meeting.
I told you about it the minute I walked through the front door.
That's only because Mim saw you both.
Oh, come on, we're talking about... I don't mind fostering children, but fostering your mother is taking the community spirit too far.
Well, she'll be straight by tomorrow. She's got a do-it-all firm coming in. And even if she doesn't admit it, it was a nasty shot for her.
Anyway, I thought you were all for community spirit, Tom. Listening to the troubles of every middle-aged sexpot who comes your way.
Susan is not a sexpot. We were at school together, for heaven's sake.
Where at school? Behind the bike sheds. She looked the type.
You're the one to talk, aren't you? What did you put on that computer? You probably put yourself down as a teenage nymphomaniac genius. If you ask me, you get everything you deserve.
At least I'm open to new experiences.
Yeah, wide open.
And if anyone tells Mum about me and computer dating, I'm cutting them out of my will.
Well, you wouldn't have put me in it, so I'm all right. Look at that.
What?
Two kids drowned in the canal. How can people let things like that happen? I'm going jogging.
With knees like that, you'll ruin your chance for a big transfer fee.
Oh, shut up.
Tom!
I've got to get out.
What about Lisa's drama group?
Don't worry about it. Mark, you're taking Lisa to drama now.
Oh, thanks, Dad.
And so... On my left,
what's up with him?
Could have picked a different colour, Gran. Lisa's made sure I'll be very comfortable, and I promise that she'll hardly know I'm there.
Well, at least you won't be taking a bicycle to bed with you like Trudy did.
Do you have to make jokes at Trudy's expense?
No, sorry, Dad. It's just something to say.
Well, just try and think before you speak. Excuse me, I'm in a hurry.
You haven't forgotten about my drama group, have you?
No, Mark's taking it.
Is that a good idea?
Will people keep off my back for a couple of seconds, please?
Don't worry about it, love.
Oh, the rain. Come comes a pitter-patter.